Thank you. Now, this year we have this as much as wheat will. Right. This is as far as I've gone with the tractor now. The last video I showed you when I dismantled the tractor, which is the power tiller tractor, I dismantled it, separating the tiller side and with the gearbox. And then I brought the tractor inside the workshop and then built the frame for it. And then I put the whole gearbox on this tractor now. And I've also prepared for the mounting of the engine here over here. We have managed to do the back axle for the tires. So the gearbox and the tires are all fitted together. And I should still be able to work out on the seat for the tractor and also finalize the gear lever. So this tractor, I've never seen it before. So I bought this tractor without knowing how it operates. So I had to go online to watch a few videos, and fortunate enough, I found the video about this power tiller. So it showed me areas where I can be able to work on and do the changing of the gears. And I tried to understand how this whole thing works. So yeah, I was able to figure out which one is the forward, which one is the reverse of the tractor. So all I need to do is now to make sure that I find the position for the gear lever, and then we can be able to change gears. The next step is for me to find the right tires. The tires that I've managed, I bought these two tires for the front, but unfortunately, the tires are different. They're not the same. The other one is bigger than the other one. So I need to find the right tires. Either I have to find one of the tires, either of the tires, and to find its pairing tire. Once I do that, I have to now start working on the suspension, the front suspension. Then I can start organizing the steering mechanism, the seating over here, and also find out how I can connect the pulley system on the engine to the pulley system that is going to be on the gearbox over here. So yeah, this is how far I've gone. One step at a time. We're getting somewhere. One of these days I'll be able to ride on this tractor and drive it. So I'm going to be showing you a video of how the process of manufacturing this tractor went along. So enjoy your video. Thank you very much for watching. And also don't forget to like the video. It's very important, because then YouTube is going to recommend this video to other people. Don't forget to share it also for some other people who can be able to see, and leave a comment to share your ideas, what you think about the tractor. Do you think that I'm doing it the right way, and do you think that maybe I'm not doing it the right way? Let me just quickly show you by sitting on the tractor, so you can just see how it's going to be like. Okay, I haven't put the seat here yet, so there's still supposed to be a seat, so I'll be somewhere around here when there's a seat. So, but at the moment, I'm here. Yeah, so this is going to be my gear lever. So when you go down, it will be like reverse, and then the forward, and the middle part is going to be neutral. There's also some gear levers here for fast and slow. Yeah, so I'm going to have my steering mechanism over here. And then I see that there's going to be a belt that comes here. So I don't know if I'm going to have enough space for me to be here, but yeah, you know, somehow it's getting there. So I would need your suggestions for those who have worked with such type of a tractor, to tell me what you think. Do you think that I'm going in the right direction, or maybe I am misreading myself? But your input is going to be very important.
Okay, that's all.
Yeah, so we want to try the tractor and see what's going to happen. I've put on some brakes on it. We'll see to see, check if the brakes are working. But let's see how the tractor operates. Okay, this tractor will be able to spray chemicals in the farm. It is going to be able to plow the farm. It's going to be able to transport goods. It's going to be able to till the land. You're going to plant seeds with the same tractor. So yeah, but right now we're just trying to be seeing how it's going to be moving before we do the other adjustments. All right. Now I'm able to sit on the tractor and I can be able to ride the tractor. It hasn't been very easy because there was a lot of things that I had to figure out. As you know, I'm not an engineer, so I have to learn on the line how to build the tractor. As you can see, I've managed to build the axle where I'm putting the wheels of the tractor. I've done the pulley system, which acts like a crash for the tractor. And then there's a gearbox over here, which also manages to move the tractor. As you can see over that side, is that I've put a mounting for the engine. And if you come to my side here, I've got this lever that does acceleration of the tractor. And then over here, I've got a clutch system, which helps the tractor to move. And I didn't forget to put a brake. So I've got a brake pedal, if you can look over here, which actually simply just presses against the wheel at the bottom. There are a few more things that I need to do. I need to fix the seat to put to make it comfortable. As you can see, it's not that much comfy. And as you can see, there's also wiring here. This wiring is for the system. The tractor is going to have brake lights. It's going to have indicator lights and lights so that you can be able to work at night. You can also drive it on the road. So yeah, the indicator lights and the brake lights is to show other drivers that, yeah, just to make the tractor to be roadworthy. It's a diesel engine tractor with about engine that has got about 12 horsepower. Then at the moment I'm busy working on the accessories or the attachments that you will be putting on the tractor. I can put attachments at the back here when I'm working on the farm, but I can also put attachments on the tractor and use it as a push tractor. So I don't have to be sitting on here, I can actually physically push the tractor. In front, I'll put some attachments also so that when you are spraying chemicals on the farm, you can put it there. If you want to use it as a pump to pump water, if you want to use that as a something that wants to mow the grass, you can also mow the grass. So now the most interesting part, to start the tractor. So I'm going to start the tractor and just do a short drive up to the end of this balcony. So that you can see how the tractor is moving. So let's hope the tractor is going to be able to start.